Welcome to the vast and infinite realm of the multiverse. There's nothing quite like it in all of science, physics, space, or theoretical thinking. It's a concept that essentially laughs in the face of most mainstream models on how the world works, and provides us instead with an endless, glittering, constantly regenerating expanse of potential. By now, thanks in large part to various works of science fiction, we of course know that the multiverse is multiple universes, a web of realities that's in some way entangled to form the true, wider, total physical structure that we are but a tiny part of. It's parallel dimensions and alternate realities. It's bridges, wormholes, quantum phenomena, and time travel. It's thrilling and it's disconcerting. Thankfully then, some have at least tried to make even a little bit of sense out of it all. And today we're moving through the many levels of one explanation of the multiverse in particular. This is Unveiled. And today we're taking an in-depth look at the 9 types of multiverse, according to the theoretical physicist, Brian Greene.
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
Brian Greene is a U.S. physicist and mathematician. He was born in New York City, graduated Harvard and Oxford. He's a professor at Columbia University. And he founded and chairs the World Science Festival. He's also deeply integrated in the modern history of the multiverse. In 2012, Greene released his book, The Hidden Reality: Parallel Universes and the Deep Laws of the Cosmos. In it, he outlines one of the most comprehensive attempts to explain the multiverse in full, dividing it all into 9 more specific categories. While variations of the categories had been seen and debated before by others, Greene pulls them all together in a bid to finally nail down the true nature of reality. Number 1. The Quilted Multiverse. In general, this is the simplest of all of Greene's multiverse types. The Quilted Multiverse only really requires this universe to be infinite, which many believe that it is. From there, all manner of arguably quote-unquote parallel worlds are possible. It certainly works in theory, because in an infinite structure, everything should be and happen an infinite number of times, including all possible variations of physical matter. Greene suggests that it's only due to the universal speed limit, the speed of light, that we're wholly unaware of the multiverse we're in. If true, one of the implications is that not only do we share this universe with other life forms, but we share it with other versions of ourselves. Naturally, we know that life, the likes of which we find on Earth, is possible, because we're the proof of it. So in the Quilted Multiverse, somewhere beyond the catchment of light speed, life as we know it should happen again and again and again, an infinite number of times. On a larger scale, the same should be true for planets and stars, meaning that in this quilted reality, there should be other instances of Earth and the Sun, of our entire solar system, exactly as we know them. And in fact, there should be an infinite number of other solar systems just like this one. The other implication is that if we could only find a way to travel beyond light speed, then we would eventually discover this multiverse with our own eyes. In simple terms, it should be only a matter of traveling in any direction for long enough before we inevitably encounter ourselves again. As to all of the other variations of life, matter, and energy that we might find along the way, it's a patchwork of yet more infinite possibilities. Number 2. The Inflationary Multiverse. Sometimes referred to as the bubble multiverse, this rendering asks us to take our first major step away from the conventional cosmos as we typically know it. The inflationary multiverse is born out of eternal inflation theory, which says that at the highest level, our reality is always expanding, and that an event such as the Big Bang could actually be caused by that expansion rather than being the cause of it. Along our own timeline, we know that there was a period of extremely rapid expansion that occurred fractions of a second after our universe began. During this fleeting moment, space-time grew faster than light speed. A subatomic speck was transformed into a sprawling expanse teeming with energy and potential, and this initial burst set everything in motion. But in the higher, wider, inflationary multiverse, it didn't happen just once. Such inflation wasn't an isolated event, but was and is an ongoing process occurring in different regions at different times. Like popcorn kernels popping endlessly in a vast cosmic popper, Each kernel represents potential universes within bubbles that are expanding within higher dimensional space. But no one piece of popcorn pops at exactly the same time, nor in exactly the same way. Scaled up to multiverse level, this means that every bubble universe that's created isn't just separate, but should also have its own unique laws and parameters. The laws of physics that we know are universal, yes, but perhaps they aren't multiversal. Every bubble stands alone. One might have stronger gravity, for example, or no electromagnetism. Another could be teeming with forms of matter that are fundamentally alien to us. Number 3, the brain multiverse. With its roots in M theory, an extension of string theory that requires 11 dimensions to work, the brain multiverse model also suggests that everything we know exists as just one of many on another higher plane. This time, however, the universe is a three-dimensional membrane floating in a higher dimensional space, sometimes called the bulk or hyperspace. Brain cosmologists also suggest that the infinite nature of reality should mean that there are endless other membranes out there, all also suspended in the same broader structure. One key implication, however, is that it might be possible for separate membranes to interact, and for those interactions to then have a profound effect. From our point of view, perhaps our membrane, our universe, has before collided with another. Or maybe we've spent our entire 13.8 billion years overlapping with a nearby membrane, another reality, which has then in some way shaped this reality in a fundamental sense. The brain multiverse also triggers all new considerations when it comes to potentially moving through the multiverse. Whereas in the quilted and to some degree inflationary models, traveling the multiverse may only ever boil down to reaching and breaking light speed. In the brain, a would-be traveler would need to physically cross over from this world to another. Number 4, the cyclic multiverse. This grade of multiverse is closely related to the previous brain model, but it rests on one idea in particular. In the cyclic multiverse, membrane universes certainly do interact with each other, and in the most profound way possible, because collisions between brains are here what double up as Big Bang events. Now the multiverse assumes a more dynamic and even more eternal regenerative trait, as the membranes in the bulk also become the birthers of other universes, just by being there. The precise mechanics of how a membrane collision could cause something as dramatic as a singularity cascading into life are unknown, but if true, it's a model that repaints hyperspace as being something like an easel, upon which a chain reaction of creation is constantly unfolding. Of course, this is hardly the only cyclic model in cosmology in general. The Big Bounce theory has fallen in and out of favor over the years, suggesting that universal expansion will one day halt and everything will contract back inwards from that point, until such time as it's all compacted back down into a singularity and the Big Bang happens again. At that moment, it could be said that the universe will have been bounced back out into space. The cyclic multiverse, by comparison, employs a similar logic, but on an even grander scale. Number 5, the landscape multiverse. Next, and we're heading full tilt into string theory, probably the most well-known attempt at a quote-unquote theory of everything there is. It posits that the fundamental constituents of reality are one-dimensional vibrating strings, rather than point-like particles. And one of many things that this would affect is the makeup of the multiverse. In general, string theory allows for many different ways in which its strings can vibrate, and each mode of vibration corresponds to a different elementary particle. Meanwhile, and as a result of that, reality is really divided into many more dimensions than just the three space plus time that we're familiar with. There are then many possible shapes that all of those extra dimensions can take when they're compacted down. In fact, there could be an effectively endless number of shapes possible, each leading to an all-new universe with its own distinct set of physical laws. The landscape of the landscape multiverse, then, pitches these different universes as though they exist along a never-ending series of hills and valleys. Every universe of the multiverse appears somewhere along this structure. Some are more stable than others, but none are identical. All are unique. In this view, our universe just so happens to reside in one valley within this broader landscape created by the fundamentals of string theory. And our particular set of physical laws corresponds to just one way in which strings can vibrate. But all the while, there are infinite other valleys and environments out there, to represent all other universes with different laws derived from their own unique vibrational patterns and their own unique shape taken as a result. Number 6. The Quantum Multiverse. Along with the Quilted Multiverse, this is probably the most widely known and discussed of all Greene's 9 types. The Quantum Multiverse suggests that at every moment when a choice or diversion is made, a new universe is created along with the one we inhabit. It works on both the micro and macro levels and is best laid out by the famed Many Worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics. On the quantum level, due to various phenomena, including the observer effect and wave function collapse, we know that particles can be one thing or another until they eventually settle down into what they ultimately become. But the quantum multiverse imagines that nothing is lost as reality takes shape, that all possible outcomes take place just along an endless mesh of different timelines. These timelines, or what some refer to as parallel worlds, are constantly branching off from the one you're in right now, which in itself has branched off of uncountable others in the past. It's perhaps more satisfying to visualize at a larger scale, though. Consider all of the choices you've already made today, what you had for breakfast, what you said to a colleague, how many YouTube videos you've watched, whether or not you scratched behind your left ear, switched your alarm to snooze, or tripped on your own doorstep. You might think of some of your actions as being more consequential than others, but in the quantum multiverse, they're all equally valuable, because they all spawn parallel worlds of what could have been. Apply the same thinking to every single quantum fluctuation that's happening all around you countless times during every single second of your existence, and the sheer density of this particular multiverse becomes clear. Some strands of it will almost be indistinguishable from the one along which you're currently living, but still, take just a short journey through it, and you could very quickly end up in an entirely alien place. Number 7. The Holographic Multiverse. This wouldn't be a video about the true underlying physics of reality without at least a passing mention of black holes, and this is that mention. The holographic multiverse builds on the holographic principle, which says that our three-dimensional reality could be encoded on a two-dimensional plane. That everything we know, from stars and planets to cars and sandwiches, is actually projected from that 2D structure to generate our universe. It ties back to black holes as a possible solution for the black hole information paradox. This is the realization that information is seemingly lost in black holes that eventually evaporate away, despite that apparently being impossible as per the conventional laws of physics. Grand cosmic holography isn't the only or even the most well-supported solution, but for advocates, it could be that the seemingly lost information within a black hole is actually encoded in 2D along the event horizon. Apply a similar model to the entirety of the universe, and it could well be a process that happens time and time and time again. And suddenly, the multiverse begins to feel like a multiplex cinema with multiple movies, or realities, playing across multiple screens, or spaces. Perhaps more than any other model up until this point, it could quickly make you feel quite inconsequential, suggesting as it does that at your root, you're not even a three-dimensional being. However, and as with all proposed multiverse types, it can also be easily argued that really, it doesn't matter. That even if life, the universe, and everything is a hologram, nothing actually changes from our point of view. Number 8. The Simulated Multiverse. This is another of the more widely known multiverse possibilities, given how it's permeated pop culture in recent times. Born out of the simulation hypothesis, as proposed by Nick Bostrom, it says that our universe is first and foremost a product of complex digital code, that everything we know, see, and feel is only ever the result of a program that's running on some far-off supercomputer in a higher dimension. For those in favor, it might even be argued that a simulated multiverse is inevitable so long as technology progresses. In our own world, we've seen how computer-simulated games and virtual reality experiences have become more and more lifelike over a relatively short period of time, to the point that some have predicted it may be impossible to tell the difference between the real world and a simulated environment in the future. Ideas on the simulated multiverse simply approach that line of thinking from a different perspective. Because what if, for some other higher, more advanced civilization or entity, that line has already been passed, and we're the ones being convinced or tricked by it? What if our world is just a very good sim? Traditionally, so to speak, it was an idea that led some to envisage one single controller or player, a supreme godlike being who's watching over our every move, because they've designed every single thing about us. But combine all the potential for a simulated reality with the endless repetition of a multiverse, and you quickly land on something even bigger. If simulated universes are possible, and if multiple universes are possible, then all that we know could and even should be just one variation of cosmic code in amongst an endless stream. Consider that we ourselves have constructed simulated realities, albeit quite primitive and superficial at present. This would mean that our controller created us to create and control others. So why not a creator for our controller to control them while they control us, while we control our sims, and so on? Then consider that comparable chains must surely be erupting an infinite number of times along an infinite number of other chains, and we again have one of the deepest and densest multiverses imaginable. Number 9. The ultimate multiverse. Finally, to an effectively unknowable multiverse that represents the most expansive and all-encompassing of all concepts possible. In this view, every conceivable universe with every possible set of physical laws and constraints exists within a grand cosmic collection. Imagine that you could lay all of everything we've covered in this video out on the table and bag it up. The ultimate multiverse is that bag. Sometimes referred to as the mathematical multiverse, and directly comparable to Max Tegmark's Level 4 multiverse, it transcends all possible constraints that might be placed on any other multiverse version. In this staggering vision, not only are there universes like ours with slight variations, or even like ours but with radical differences, there are also universes that are governed by completely different mathematics. This means that any form of logical or mathematical structure that can exist does exist as a separate reality somewhere within this overriding ultimate landscape. In this way, most of it is impossible for us to even picture, given the limited view that we inescapably have. It's a fine structure that pushes infinitely far beyond our understanding of physics, because it suggests that our own universe's laws, everything from quantum mechanics to general relativity, are not uniquely fundamental in any way whatsoever. Instead, we're merely cast adrift in an endless sea of theoretical frameworks. While highly speculative and abstract, contemplating such a multiverse challenges us to reconsider what we deem as necessary truths about existence in general. It opens up profound questions about reality's true nature and our place within it. It may be, then, that our universe isn't just one page in a much longer book, but that it's one page in an endless library. For some, the ultimate multiverse could even lead to a multiverse of multiverses, contained only by the one truth that it cannot be contained. So what do you think? Which of Brian Greene's 9 types of multiverses do you think hits closest to the truth? Or are you unconvinced by the idea of a multiverse in any form? Let us know your take in the comments. For now, while the prospect of a multiverse is increasingly covered in contemporary science, it remains true that, at its heart, there are questions that humankind has always wrestled with and will always wonder about. Why are we here? What is our purpose? How real is real? And what does tomorrow hold? Importantly, the multiverse has yet to be proven, but it's an idea that's very much alive and challenging us all to take a higher, wider view. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled. And make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.